Today we're going to talk about NDI and NDI and its capabilities with GrandMA3. And what is NDI? NDI is a network device interface, which is like a standard protocol you can use across all different manufacturers, and it transmits video on your local area network. And we can use the GrandMA3 to watch these transmissions, and that is pretty cool and really helpful. The first thing you want to do is you want to go into NDI Tools, and you want to download or go into Tools here, and you want to go in and download the NDI Tool package for the operating system you use. If you are a Mac user, you're going to use the Mac version, of course, and there's a Windows version as well. And when you have downloaded the entire package, you want to start up this one down here called NDI Screen Capture. And there's a bit of configuration you can do on it. On my screen here in the background, you can see I have a video running, and I'm using NDI Tools or NDI Screen Capture to capture what's happening on my screen and to capture my webcam as well, so I can have that available on the network. And right now I have that, and I have a MacBook here next to me, which has the same NDI tool installed, and that's going to transmit an image as well. The next thing you want to do is you want to go into your console and you want to set up your connector number 2 or connector number 3 to be part of your network. In my case, I use connector number 3, and what you should think about is never to use connector number 1 or wherever your MA network is. My experience is you can't use NDI on the same connector as your MA3 net is using, and I think that has something to do with bandwidth. They are protecting MA3 net to make sure that it doesn't get congested. NDI takes up quite a bit of bandwidth, so be careful when you're using NDI. You can pretty easy use all the bandwidth you have available on any given connector, so just be careful. An NDI signal is about 100, 120, 140 megabits per second, so if you have 5 or 6 of them, you have basically filled up your entire one gigabit connection. So be aware of that. But if you have downloaded NDI Tools, if you are having a laptop next to you or a computer next to you, and you are transmitting an NDI signal, we can go straight into MA3 now, and I'll show you how to set it up in there. So the first thing we want to do is we want to create a pool over here with our videos in it. So we say video and our video pool. The next thing you want to do is you want to have your appearances handy, so you can assign videos to appearances. The last thing we need here is our layout pool that gives us the option to switch between inputs of different sorts. So here, and the last thing up here is our layout view, which gives us the option to watch what's going on our network. So we have our videos here. If you go into pool number 1, use your swipey and say edit. We can, up here under source, we can, instead of file, choose NDI, and then we go down to select source, and we simply select, in our case here, our MSI computer, and you can see the image on the screen is the same image as you see in the background right now. So that's the first one. We can label it MSI screen. The next thing we could do is we could add the camera as well. So we go into source here and we say camera, and that should be the camera from my laptop up here. And we label that MSI camera like this. And the last signal is our MacBook. And we select source and we go to our MacBook down here, and that should give us the image coming straight from my MacBook. So this is basically 3 images coming from 2 different computers into GrandMA3. The next thing we want to do is we want to find an empty appearance here somewhere, and we simply want to go into the appearance, and we want to go, instead of images up here, you want to choose video, and we just made 3 videos or input signals, and you can say MSI screen as the first one, and we should get a preview down here. And once again, we need to label it. You don't have to label it, but I just find it really handy when you need to assign them later on that you know what is what. We assign the camera in the next one, and we label that MSI camera like this. And the last one is our MacBook. We assign our MacBook to the last input and we label that one as well, MacBook. Now we are ready to assign our appearance, assign each input into our appearances. So it's really simple. You say MSI screen, you say assign to layout one, and that should give us our first image into MA3 from NDI. And we can do the next with the camera. Oops. We can do the next here with the camera, assign that into the next input, and we can choose it. And you can see, hello, the camera is here, and the MacBook in the last one here. And we should be able to choose our MacBook like this. And once again, I think I'll just label these to make sure we remember what is what here. MSI camera, and we just choose the MacBook as the last one. There we go. So this is basically how easy it is to set NDI up in GrandMA3. It is extremely easy and it's really, really powerful if you want to use, if you have like cameras on stage and you want a preview of these cameras, you can put it into say OBS or you could put it into different sorts of equipment transmitting NDI signals. And you could basically just make like a composition of different images and put that into to GrandMA. I mean, there's so many different things you can use this for, and that's why it is so powerful to have that in your GrandMA3. Also, if you have like a media server and you want to see if it's a hypnotizer, you have the zookeeper, which tells you what's going on, what clips are selected and stuff like that. So you could transmit the zookeeper signal to your console. So if there's something not working, you can go into your NDI input and you can see if it's reacting on stage, if it's maybe you that is making a problem somewhere. When you have done everything in your setup and it's ready to go, you can, as usual, just store this in a view somewhere and say, this is our NDI sources, like this, and you can work with your console as you're used to, and when you need to see something, you simply just go into your NDI and have a look. And when you made your view, it's pretty simple to go up to our console, copy it to another screen, and then we have it on both screens. I don't know if you can see it back here, but if I open screen number two here on my computer and drag it up here, you can see I have the exact same thing going on here. So you can move it across the screens like any other view. Another fun little feature you can use with your appearance and your videos, if you go into your user setup right here in your settings, user configuration, you can go into your current user. In my case, it's just the admin user, and you can assign the MSI screen, for instance, to your lock screen. So if you lock your computer, you can see this is, if I lock this one as well, this is basically our lock screen is now a video running of our NDI signal. So just be careful what you put on the screen. So as you can see, there's so many different use cases where you can use NDI into your GrandMA3 system, and it's just really valuable to be able to do that. So that's a really cool feature of GrandMA3. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, you are more than welcome to give it a like. It's going to indicate to YouTube that you liked it, and it's going to spread it out to more people. And if you just can't get enough of MA3 tutorials, you can subscribe to the channel and make sure the little bell notification is left on, and that's going to give you a notification every time we upload a new video here on the Event Lighting channel. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope that you will get some really happy GrandMA3 programming moments out there. See you next time. Bye bye.